Thank you. Good morning, church. Praise the Lord for another Sunday, no? So if ay katong nasa likod, pwede pa ta mo ari sa front, no? Madaghan-daghan pa man tag vacant. Praise God. No, and advance Merry Christmas dai, no? So tunga-tunga na ta sa buwan sa December. Hapit na sad mahuman ang tuig. And muna, I think, kanang medyo busy na sad ang mga schedule sa mga tao, no? Kay parties left and right. Lagan kay gipang atenan and muna, some of our church members here, kung naasad sa line outreach as they attend some parties, no? But despite of that, wala dyan makapugong sa ato ang pagdaig o pagsimba sa itong buhi nga Diyos karong kabuntagon. Sige, so before anything else, may I request everyone to open your Bible. Before we start, as we worship our living God, open your Bible in Psalm 107, verses 1 to 9. Psalm 107, verses 1 to 9. May I request everyone to please stand as we give respect, as we read the Word of God. It says here, "O give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His steadfast love endures forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom He has redeemed from trouble, and gathered from the lands, and from the east, and from the west, and from the north, and from the south. Some wandered in the desert waste, finding no way to the city to dwell in. Hungry and thirsty, their soul fainted within them." In verse 6, "Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and He delivered them from their distress. He led them by a straight way till they reached a city to dwell in. Let them thank the Lord for His steadfast love, for His wondrous works to the children of men, for He satisfies the longing soul and the hungry soul. He fills with good things." Praise be the Lord. It says in verse 1, "Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His steadfast love endures forever." Praise be the Lord, no? Indeed, our God is worthy of all our praises. Ang kanyang praise, no, nga, "Oh, give thanks to the Lord," it emphasized, no, with exclamation, nga, naagi strong conviction, no? Ang iyahang intense ba nga, "Church, let us give thanks to the Lord." Why? Because He is good. Amen? Maayo gayud ang atong buhi nga Dios. His goodness will be revealed all throughout the rest of this psalm. Kung atong basahon ng tibuok nga psalm, no, nga Psalm 107, it talks about of God's goodness sa iyang mga katawhan, no? And even sa atong mga kinabuhi, no, matag-usa ka nato. We have to give thanks to the Lord for His wonderful works na gibuhat sa itong kinabuhi. And kung ato lang hinumduman, no, from the passage that we've read, no, remember the story of the people that God redeemed them from the slavery in the Egypt. As they journey to the promised land, but along the way they wander in the desert land, and they were hungry and thirsty, and their soul fainted. But when they cried out to the Lord for help in trouble of the wilderness, the redeemed cried out to the Lord, no, and God answered. He delivered them from their distress. And He led them forth to the right way, that God leads His redeemed people to the right place. We're a city in the dwelling place. So kana, no, makita nang nato nga kung unsa ka maayo ang buhi nga Dios, kung unsa ka kuan siya ba ka merciful sa imong kaanakan sa dihang muduol ka kaniya. And He is even a God who supplies, no, satisfy the longings of the soul. And muna, no, sama sa mga Israelites, kitang mga kaanakan niya, sometimes we still wonders in this worldly, no. Nagwonder pa ta kung unsay mga butang nga makapahatag natong satisfaction aning kalibutan na. Especially kung sa panahon nga nagkalisod or our lives become so shaky, no. We tend to look for other things, no, for other solution nga ka because our journey in this life, no, grabe kayo ka, kalisod. And mo, ano, sometimes we tend to look for other ways nga mo'y makapahatag na tuog. Kagka, kanang pangita na tuog satisfaction sa tong kinabuhi. But yet, in His great mercy and love, no, ang gugma sa Ginoo, iyahang gipakita sad ang iyahang kaayo, sa dihang kitang muduol gayod kaniya. Sa dihang mo surrender ta, atong kinabuhi, atong isurrender diha sa Ginoo, no? Iyang gipakita ang iyang pagkamaayo. And that phrase, no, nga, He satisfied the longing of the soul. Walang lang na nagpasabot, no, nga, tungod katong mga Israelites during those times sa wilderness, ang hunger and thirsty. Wala lang ka na mo'y giiyahang gisupply, no, or wala lang, dili lang kadto ang iyahang gihatag o katagbawan, but even the hunger and so and the thirsty of our soul within us mo'y gitagbaw sa Ginoo. Ug sama sad ka na nga natik, matag-usa ka na to, no. The longing of our soul, it is God alone who satisfy. And muna, no, sa karong katuiga, karong for the whole year of year 2023, daghan man sa mga nangaagian, no, we may tend to question or sometimes it wonders us nga unsay mga panghitabo, no, na nahitabo karong tuiga. We really don't understand, no, the ways of God. But nakita na to na despite of all the troubles, all the fears na atong nakita or na atong naagian, but still God iyang gipakita ang iyang pagkamaayo, iyang pagka-faithful sa matag usa ka nato. Wala ta niya pasagdi. Buhi ang atong buhi nga Dios, and the same God kung unsa siya kamaayo sa mga Israelites before, the same God who will supply our need today, the same God who will satisfy our soul, the same God nga mao'y maghatag ka nato og pagiya sa matag-adlaw nato. And that is why, no, ni ana gyud ang psalmist, let us give thanks to the Lord. And even that word alone, no, that you redeem people, kana lang nga word nga redeem, usa lamang na kadako nga rason nga nganong angayan ta nga mudayg o magpasalamat sa Ginoo. Because we, His people, no, deserve the wrath of God. But because of His grace, no, gipundok ta diri. Tungod sa iyang grasya o kalooy, sa iyang pagkamaayo sa itong kinabuhi, gigrasyahan lang gigid kita, nga kita makaduol sa itong buhi nga Dios. And Mona, no, at all times we should give thanks, and every day, because every day sa itong kinabuhi, He's been so good, He's been so faithful, He's been so merciful and loving towards us. So let's just come before the Lord in prayer, no? Let's bow down our heads. Let's just worship and adore our living God. Hallelujah, O God. Oh, we sing of your goodness. Sing of your faithfulness, O God. Indeed, O Lord, you are so good. Walay sama kanimo, O Dios. Worthy is your name, O God, of all the praises, of all the glory, of all the adoration, because you are the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Creator of the heavens and the earth. Lord, walay sama kanimo, O Lord. Ikaw ang Dios nga buhi, ang Dios nga labing gamhanan. You are greatly to be praised, O God. And none can compare to you, Father God. None can compare to your great love, O God. That even in these things of this world, Father God, wala gayoy makakumpara, O Lord. It's only you who satisfy our souls, O God. We thank you for your great love towards sa amo tag-usa nga ri sa makinabuhi, O God. Mapasalamaton kami, O Lord, even, O God, sa imuhang grasya matag-adlaw, Lord, that you have sustained us day by day, Lord. It's all by your grace. It's all for your mercy, O God. Lord, each of us, O God, among mga kasing-kasing, puno sa mga sala. Father God, puno sa lama. But Lord, we thank you for your precious blood. We thank you for your great mercy that you have died on the cross. Na kami, Lord, makaduol, makasimba sa kadako sa imong kaayo, Lord. Lord, salamat, salamat, O God. Oh, we praise you, Lord. Oh, we sing of your goodness, O God. Thank you, Jesus. Let's just declare that indeed our God is good all the time.
Keep you safe and sound. He has promised.
forever you are faithful, oh God. Oh, we sing, oh God. Oh, we praise you. We'll give you thanks, oh God, for everything that you have done in our lives, oh God. Lord, we thank you. Grateful for what you have done, Lord. Lord, give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever, for He is good, He is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise. With a mighty hand and outstretched arm, His love endures forever. For the life that's been reborn, His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever. From the rising to the setting sun, His love endures forever, and by the grace of God we will carry. Love endures forever. Hallelujah. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Sing. Thank you indeed for your word, O God, for what you have promised, O God. Imo gayud kaning tinud-on, Father God. Indeed, your word is ever true, O Lord. Lord, mahanaw man ang tanan, Father God, but ang imuhang pulong nagapabilin, O God. indeed you are faithful in our lives, O God. That as we think of your goodness, Lord, Lord, forever we are grateful. Forever, O God, ikaw lamang, O Lord, ang pasalamatan sa mong kinabuhi, O Lord. Tungod sa kadako, si mong gugma, kanoy ka na mo, Lord. Wala ka na gabiya. Never fail us. Never forsaken us, O God. You have shown, O God, your great love sa matag-usa, O Lord. You are our joy. You are our all in all, O God. You satisfy us, O Jesus. And no one compares to you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Dalaygon ka lamang, Lord. His goodness. Think about His grace that brought us through. For as high as the heavens above, so great is the measure of our Father's love. Great is the measure of our Father's love. Think about His love. Think about His love. Think about His goodness. Think about His grace that brought us through. For us It's fine.
Goodness of God. And all my goodness of God. All my life you've been faithful. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness. Yes, Lord. Oh, we sing of your goodness. Sing of your faithfulness in our lives, O God. Indeed, O God, you alone is worthy of all praises, of all honor and glory, O God. Lord, none can compare to you, Father God. Lord, ikaw lamang ug walay laing ngalan ang angayan nga mudawat sa tanang pagdaig ug pagsimba, O God. And all we all say, amen and amen. Praise be the Lord God. Panglingkod ng tanan. Amen. So, before tamo padayon, no? So, nabatay newcomer karong kabuntagon. Think natin mga bisita. First time pamakari. So, we would like to request na Marita sa front, we just like to welcome you with the love of the Lord. So, Marita, praise the Lord. Kay natay bagong kuano, karela naka-join. So, we praise the Lord. And kita, mga karaan, atong i-welcome sila with the love of the Lord. Front. She sings song. She loves you, my friend. So kita, mamalik tag barog, no? Mamarog tag balik. As we greet each other with a great smile, kumusta? Nasa kilid.
Good morning. Merry Christmas. 15 days. Praise the Lord for that. Kay hapit na pud matapos ang tuig. But salamat gihapon no sa iyang grasya ug kaluoy nga nakita gihapon ta mo nga nagpadayon diha sa pagsimba ug pagpangalagad sa Ginoo. And before I'll go to the word of God, I have some announcement to make. This coming December 17, mauna ang atong unsa Christmas party or Christmas gathering. This coming December 17, same time gihapon kung unsa ta oras nag fellowship. And ari ra ta ha, di tamang gawas. So ari ra gihapon ta sa center. Ayaw kalimot ha, December 17, karong Sunday. So wala tay kanang color coding ani. Just bring kanang pinaka best ninyo nga isulob, kana lang makapahimaya sa Ginoo. So praise the Lord. And another announcement I would like to make is the young adults, the youth and the young adults fellowship kay nag nasa mi Christmas break. So by January, hopefully God willing, mobalik na ang amuang service sa mga wala nakahibalo, no? And basig na may mga anak ba nga moadto kog youth nya wa na ra ba youth. So so wala sa tay youth for this whole month of December. Amen. And lastly is I would like to greet a happy birthday for kinsa may nag-birthday for the month of December. Raise your hands. Raise your hands. Praise the Lord. Can we all stand katong mag-birthday of December? Praise the Lord. Kung kinsay pinakaduol ninyo no nga person, you can stretch your hands to them and we can pray for them. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father God in heaven, Lord, we thank you and we come before you with a grateful hearts for you are good sa matag-usa kakinabuhi ni ining mga celebrants karon. And Lord, we celebrate the gift of life sa ilahang special day. We thank you, Lord, for this individual that who will be celebrating their birthday this month. We pray and we believe, Lord, that each of their life is a precious gift in your sight. Lord, we pray, we'll lift up this birthday celebrants to you, that your blessing be poured out upon them abundantly, and not just on their birthday, not just on their special day, but throughout the coming year, Lord, sa ilang kinabuhi. Grant them joy, grant them peace, diha sa ilahang kasing-kasing. May they continue to grow, O God, in wisdom and draw closer to you with each passing day, Lord God. May their lives be a light and salt to the people around them. Lord, we pray that whatever trials and struggles they are in right now, we commit them into your hands. We also pray that you would continue to give them the desire to be used by you and to walk blameless without reproach, O God. And once again, Lord God, we commit them into your hands, O Lord. To yours alone be the glory, the power, dominion, and authority. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Happy birthday. Salamat sa Ginoo. And for today's preaching, I entitled this Glowing in the Dark. Glowing in the Dark. So if you have your Bibles with you, join me to read in Philippians chapter 2, verse 14 to 18. Philippians chapter 2, verse 14 to 18. May I request, can we all stand as we read God's word? Ako ning basahon diya sa English Standard Version. It says here, do all things without grumbling or disputing, that you may be blameless and innocent children of God, without blemish in the midst of crooked and twisted generation, among whom you shine as lights in the world, holding fast to the word of life, so that in the day of Christ I may be proud that I did not run in vain or labor in vain. Verse 17, even if I am to be poured out as a drink offering upon the sacrificial offering of your faith, I am glad and rejoice with you all. Likewise, you also should be glad and rejoiced with me. Let's pray. Father God in heaven, Lord, thank you for your words, O God. Thank you for your presence. Lord, as we continue to hear your word today, I am praying that we can apply kung unsang imuhang gipanudlo diri kanamo Ginoo. And Lord, as we walk in this dark world, O Father God, we pray we will glow and we will shine, O God, as light in this world. We pray, Lord God, that we will walk blameless in your sight. We pray, Lord God, as we listen to your word today, you alone be glorified. You alone be magnified. And to yours alone be the glory, the power, dominion, and authority. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You can now be seated. Can you imagine, mga igsoo, no? You are walking into a pitch black. Kanang wag yung kay makita bisag gamay nga kahayag ni ana nga kwarto. You are unable to see anything around you. Unsa may imong bation? Diba? It is disorienting and very uncomfortable. Murag sige lang kag kapakapa ba. Diba? Nga murag grabe namang gyud kangit-ngit. Di gyud murag wa kay pag-asa nga makita. Right? But then, suddenly, you notice a small object in the darkness. And it catches your attention. And unsa may buhato nimo kung makakita kag gamayng kahayag. Di ba? Muduol man ka. And as you approach, padung ka ato, you realize that it is a tiny, gamay kaayo nga, suga, radiating warmth and brightness. And in that moment, that little light becomes a beacon of hope. Uyay, Lord, salamat ining gamay kahayag ngayong mong gihatag. Diba, na'y beacon of hope and guidance in the midst of darkness. And in our world today, unsa may mong makita karon sa kalibutan, mga igsoon, it often feels like we are surrounded by darkness. Tinuod dili. We are surrounded by darkness. Darkness of negativity, darkness of division, and the darkness of despair. Murag wala na kay paglaom. And it can be overwhelming. And at the same time, discouraging kayo. And because of this kalisod sa kinabuhi, mga complexities of this generation, sayon kaayo to get caught up in grumbling and arguing. Di ba? Dali kay tang masuko. Stress kay ka. And usahay natay a general sense of dissatisfaction. You are not satisfied. And akong nakita ro no ang mga new generation. Grabe. Dali kay mangluod. Grabe, dali kay mangluod. Kasab-anay mo gamay, reklamo. Tinuod, di ba? Og di ni mo mahatag ilang gusto, reklamo. Grabe. And but just as that small glowing object, mga igsoon, stood out in the dark room, that even that smallest light gamay nga suga can disperse darkness. Bisag unsa na kagamay, makadisperse na siya sa darkness. And in the same way, also to us, mga Kristohanon, in the same way, as followers of Christ, we have the wonderful opportunity to be those glowing objects in this dark world. And where we can bring hope, where we can bring encouragement, where we can bring guidance to those who are lost and searching. And our lives, mga Kristohanon, can serve as a beacon, a good example of God's love and truth nga maoy makapadasig sa uban, nga makita nimo ang ilang kinabuhi, makita nila ang imong kinabuhi, nga mapaduol pod sila diha sa Ginoo. Amen? And before we dive into our study, let me just give you the background of Philippians. Unsa man ning naa sa Philippians. So the letter of Philippians was written by Paul when he was in prison. And most likely in Rome around AD 60. And the letter was addressed to the believers in the city of Philippi. And in his letter, mga igsoon, mabasa na nato dito, kung nabasahan na nimo ang tibuok Philippians, in his letter, he expresses his gratitude for their support sa katong mga Philippian church. Not only spiritually through prayers, of course, they were praying for Paul, but also in physical and financial aspect. Mauni nagsuporta ni Pablo not only through prayers, but physical and financial aspect. And most of all, si Pablo, mga igsoon, nag-express sa iyang gratitude with their partnership diha sa gospel. And in addition to that, he addresses some specific issues, specific concern within the church, sulod sa church, and provide guidance on how they should live as followers or believers in Christ. And he encouraged them to maintain unity within the church. Kay nakita niya nga naay disunity sulod sa church. Imo nang mabasa diya sa chapter 2 verse 1 nga niingon si Paul, to have the same mind and having the same love towards everyone. And iya pong gi-address ang issue to have humility in chapter 2, verse 3 to 4, and to be joyful in the midst of suffering and persecution. And he also warned them, again, the false teaching, and urged them to stand firm in their faith. And we, kita, isip, mga magtutuo ni Kristo in this generation, mga igsoon, is to faithfully observe and examine this commendable and exemplary teachings of Paul. Dapat ato ning tutukan, mga igsoon. And this message that we will be studying karon mo ni maghatag natog encouragement to continuously work out on our own salvation with fear and trembling, and to be a light, a glowing light in this darkened world. And this will be a great challenge for us. This will be a great challenge for us to live in such a way nga ang atong kinabuhi should be a beacon of hope, a guide in the midst of darkened and crooked world. Just as that little light, mga igsoon, kanang gamay nga suga lang, maunay maghatag o giya, maunay maghatag o paglaom sa mga tao nga muduol sila makita nimo ilang kinabuhi nga naa day kay Kristo. And especially no, ang atong mga batasan, ang atong mga actions should draw others unta ngadto paingon kang Kristo. And today we will explore how we can embrace this call to glow in the dark and to radiate joy, to radiate unity and selflessness, not only inside your house, not only in the church, not only in your workplace, but also in a world nga nagkinahanglan, that is desperately in need of light of the Savior. And let us discover together how, unsaon man nato pagka mahimong different ba? How can we make a difference by shining brightly in the midst of this dark world? And ang point lang nga gusto na kong ipaabot, mga igsoon, is isip mga magtotoo ni Kristo. As believers of Christ, it is necessary to work out your own salvation and keep glowing for Christ in this dark and twisted nga kalibutan. And I will share with you the necessary actions on how to work out on your own salvation and how to continuously glow in this dark world. And the unang butang nga akong nakita diha is stop complaining. Stop complaining. Verse 14, do all things without grumbling or disputing. Do all things without grumbling or disputing. And the word do diha, mga igsoon, the word do, kung mo hisgot kung mga English nga kuan, ang kuan gyud ana is you do. Ikaw mismo, you do all things. And the word do here is the verb. And in the present tense form, the present tense in Greek, mga igsoon, maunay siya nag-express og ongoing or continuous action. Padayon nga pagabuhaton. It is an action that's still to be done. A command in the past that needs to be done in the present. Not later, not tomorrow, but karun. Muna'y pasabot diha, you do all things without grumbling and disputing. And it needs to be done, mga igsoon, precisely. And in this case, it suggests that believers, kitang mga magtotoo ni Kristo, are to continue and to be consistent, not to grumble or to complain, but be what? Gentle and lowly. Gentle and lowly. And being gentle and lowly, mga igsoon, is a specific nga action that we should take without specifying whether it should be done daan ka usa or repeatedly, no need na na. And the focus emphasis lang yun dere is on the urgency and the importance of obeying the command rather than on its ongoing nature. Mone focus emphasis, the urgency and the importance of obeying this command. Nga naman, because as followers of Christ Jesus, we are called to be gentle and lowly in our interactions with others. This means treating people with kindness, compassion, humility, and patience. And even Jesus Christ, gitudluan ta niya in how to be gentle and how to be lowly. He teaches how important to be gentle and lowly towards sa uban. And iyan ang gihisgutan during his sermon on the mount, di ba? During his sermon on the mount as one of the Beatitudes. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 5, he says, "Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth." And meekness, magisgot gitag, meekness is kanang grabe ka mapaubsanon. Meekness is often associated with gentleness and humility. And being gentle and lowly towards others, mga igsoon, shows mutual understanding or mag-show kag empathy and respect sa imuhang isig kataw. It means avoiding harsh words or actions and seeking to build up and encourage others instead. And sometimes, due to pressure o ma-stress na gaita sa atong kinabuhi, sayon kaayo ang pagreklamo. Sayon kaayo mo grumble o mo dispute. Sayon kaayo mo complain. And worst case scenario, kusog kita mo pinpoint sa uban. We blame others. Instead, it is our fault. And it's easy to pinpoint others. Gamayng tandog, sumpadok! Diba? Yeah, Brad, what if? What if it's their fault, not mine? Mom, giniatua mo, mulusot mong kita, mangita mong kita pamaagi, di ba? What if it's their fault, not mine? And in situations when we are not at fault, being gentle and lowly, mga igsoon, maoni magtabang sa atua to respond with grace and humility rather than reacting with anger or defensiveness. Kay kusog kita mo dipinsa sa atong kaugalingon. Maunay pinakauna nga once makasala ka, imong kaugalingon, imong dipinsahan una. And this will allow us to approach conflicts na, misunderstanding, and with a desire for dapat unta nay reconciliation. Na ay understanding bisag dili ang imuhang sala. Rather than seeking to prove ourselves right or seeking revenge. Are you being gentle at the same time lowly when approaching problems that are not aligned in accord to our own plans? And there are times, sad mga igsoon nga, we grumble because nagunahuna ta nga ang atuang mga plano are bit better than her plan or his plan. Maom na atua, gusto matang mulabaw. Maom makaingon ta nga, Akabati ato yung plano, mas nindot ning ako ah, nindot ta ning plano. We grumble because we think our plans are better than his or her plan. How are you in your community? Kumusta man ta mga igsoon? What attitude you are projecting in your community? Are you gentle and lowly in your society? At the church, siguro sa church, mura gitag santos, nauta simbahan, di ba? But how about when you are outside the church? You are at home, you are in your school, in your workplace. Who are you? And maybe you will ask a question, why do we need to stop complaining? Nga nung kinahanglan man, Brad, muhunong ko. What is the purpose of doing all things without grumbling or disputing? Verse 15, muna itubag. So that you may be blameless and innocent, children of God, without blemish, in the midst of a crooked and twisted generation, among whom you shine as lights in the world. In other words, pa mga igsuon, to be godly. Be godly. Sura na birthday. Pa? Paul is encouraging us, kita, mga magtotoo ni Kristo, to stand out as examples of godly living in a world filled with negativity and conflict. Mauna pili, ah, choose not to grumble or argue. Display qualities such as patience, contentment, and humility, and this sets us apart as children of God who are striving to live according to God's standard. And as children of God, mga anak, mangyukata sa Ginoo. Amen? Wow, gamay ra siguro, mga anak. Amen? Mga anak, mangyukata sa Ginoo. Mona, stop complaining and mold yourselves to be blameless and innocent, above reproach, without fault, in the midst of a crooked and twisted generation. Display a life that is godly, a way of living na makaplease diha sa Ginoo, makaglorify sa Ginoo. Display a life that is godly in a world that is morally and spiritually broken. And sadly, makaguol lang mga igsoon because daghan kaayong mga Kristuhanon nga wala nag-display the way of a godly. They were eaten. Gikaon sila aning so-called worldly perspective where they tried to normalize the things that should not be done by a Christian. And ang una diha mga igsoon, no, is casual sex. Christians are tempted to downplay the importance of sexual purity and engage in premarital or extramarital sexual activity. 1 Corinthians 6:18 to 20. Sigingon, flee from sexual immorality and every other sin a person commit outside the body, but the spirit, the sexually immoral person sin against his own body. Or do you not know Wa ba ka kahibaw that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit? You receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You are not on your own. For you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body. And second thing is this so-called thing, divorced. And due to high divorce rates, mga igsoon, and kay baw na ka kung unsay uso, maupod. Di ba? Due to high divorce rates and acceptance sa sulod sa community, kita pong mga Kristuhanon were also influenced and view divorce is a viable solution to marital problems. Gamayng kasikas, gamayng problema sulod sa kaminyoon, magbulag ta. Mga igsoon, marriage is created by God not for your own pleasure, but His. Marriage is for God's glory, not for your own glory. As what Matthew 19 verse 6 says, so they are no longer but two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate. And napuni nato gitawag nga same-sex relationship. And with the increasing acceptance and legalization of kining matawag natog same-sex relationships, na ay mga Kristuhanon nga na-feel sila og pressure to reinterpret or ignore biblical teachings on homosexuality to align with societal norms. Klaro kay na sa Biblia, mga igsoon, in Leviticus 20:13, and it says here, if a man lies with a male as with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination before God. That is an abomination before God. And lastly, naay gitawag og gender fluidity. Chom ng gender fluidity, brad. These are the people who don't identify themselves solely as male or female. Naabaday na. Wa sila kahibaw kung lalaki ba sila o babae. And their gender identity changes over time. Na ay mga documentary ng gawas ron nga, ang mga tao, ilang gender identity is iring. Unsaon man ani mo ron? Di sila tao kay iring. They are making their own identity as male or female. And the acceptance of this kind, no, can lead some Christians to question or pwede mahitabo, mo reject sa mga biblical understanding of gender as binary. Klaro kayo sa Deuteronomy 22 verse 5, a woman shall not wear a man's garment, nor shall a man put on a woman's cloak. For whoever does these things is an abomination to the Lord your God. And many Christians represent this example. You are professing with your own mouth that you are a believer, that you are saved by the blood of Jesus Christ, but you continue to live in a manner characterized by this world. And sorry to say, there is no such thing as a carnal Christian. Nga ang imuhang katunga sa imong kinabuhi naas Ginoo, katunga sa imong kinabuhi naas kalibutan. We are called to live in a way that reflects our identity as children of God. Stand out as lights in the dark world, mga igsuod. Our actions and attitudes should draw attention to the goodness and the truth of God. And that is why live a godly life and keep your life glowing in this very dark world. But the question is, have you walked your life worthy of the calling that you have been called, mga igsuod? Have you? Even Paul, no? Iyang giingnan ang church sa Ephesians. Diha sa Ephesians chapter 4, verse 1 to 3. Ingon siya, I therefore, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to walk in a manner worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. And if our lives are still walking in darkness, we cannot walk in a manner worthy of our calling and to maintain unity in the body of the church. Kay bisag unsa pa kakadasig mga igsuon sa pagpangalagad diha sa Ginoo, unya ang imuhang kinabuhi naa gihapon ang imong kalipay diha sa kangit-ngit. I tell you, your toil, ang imong kahago, is in vain. There is no so-called Christians who walk in the light and at the same time walks in darkness. Kay ang tinuod nga Kristohanon, mga igsuon, aims to walk in the light and to be in the light. Are you walking in the light of God? Are you? Have you kept your light glowing that others may see that Jesus Christ is in you? But the question is, how? Saon man, brad? How can I be a light sa may ako ang tamdanan sa akong kinabuhi? Verse 16. Hold firmly what? To God's word. Hold firmly. Checking on verse 16. Holding fast to the word of life, so that in the day of Christ I may be proud that I did not run in vain or labor in vain. And to keep that light glowing sa atong mga kinabuhi is to hold fast to the word of life. We are to stay committed to the teachings of Christ and living according to God's word. We are called to cling tightly to the word of God, meditating and studying of Scripture. Seek His guidance and His will through God's word and allowing it to shape our attitudes and our actions. And karon ang problema, wa man tay basa-basa sa pulong sa Ginoo. Then how can we hold fast to the word of life? And why do we need to hold fast? Why do we need to hold fast to the word of life? Ngano man, unsa man day naa sa Biblia? 2 Timothy 3:16 to 17, unsa gingon? All scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in what? Righteousness. That the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work. And by holding fast to the word of life, we can live with purpose and meaning sa atong kinabuhi. Let our lives become a testimony to the transforming power of Christ. And ultimately, mga isoon, if you hold fast, if you hold firmly to the word of life, we can look forward to the day of Christ. Inigbalik sa Ginoo, we can look forward. Nga naatay confidence, mga tubang sa Ginoo. And on that day of judgment, when Christ returns, we can stand before Him knowing that we have faithfully followed and obeyed His teachings. And just like Paul, mga igsoon, we can take pride knowing that our labor in sharing the gospel and living out our faith was not in vain, mga igsoon. Our commitment to God's word will be rewarded. Amen? And we can experience the joy of hearing Him say, unsa man, unsa may gustong madunggan sa mga Kristohanon? Ha? Huh? Well done, good. What? Unfaithful servant. Matthew 25, verse 23. But the question is, are you faithful in your walk with the Lord? Are you holding firmly to His promises? And if you are holding firmly to the promises of God, how does His word shape you? How? Is your life a living testimony to the transforming power of Christ? Instead of complaining, be gentle and lowly. Rather than complaining, mga igsoon, be godly and stay committed to the word that gives life. For if you hold fast to the word of life, you will have confidence that your effort in living out your faith will not be in vain. And that is why stop complaining then start rejoicing. Stop complaining, then start rejoicing. Verse 17, unsay giingon? Even if I am to be poured out as a drink offering upon the sacrificial offering of your faith, I am glad and rejoice with you all. And if you notice, mga igsoon, the prepositional praise, kanang word nga, even if I am to be poured out, is a drink offering. That implies Paul's willingness, iyahang willingness to sacrifice himself for the sake of the believers and their faith. And in the Old Testament, balik lang ko gamay sa Old Testament para masabtan ni nato unsa maning poured out is a drink offering. A drink offering was a liquid poured out on the sacrificial offering as an act of worship and dedication diha sa Ginoo. I will go back to Exodus chapter 29, verse 38 to 41. It says, now this is what you shall offer on the altar, two lambs as a year old day by day regularly. One lamb you shall offer in the morning, and the other lamb you shall offer at twilight. And with the first lamb, a tenth measure of fine flour mingled with a fourth of a hin of a beaten oil and a fourth of a hin of wine for a drink offering. The other lamb you shall offer at twilight, and shall offer with it a grain offering, and again, and its drink offering, as in the morning, for what? A pleasing aroma, a food offering to the Lord. Paul, mga igsoon, compare his own life to this drink offering, indicating his readiness to give everything for the sake of the believers in the Philippi and their growth in faith. And Paul was not only giving everything to the Philippi believers, mga igsoon, but he also gave his everything to please and glorify the Lord. Someday gingon diha, a pleasing aroma diha sa Ginoo. Are you doing your ministry para sa Ginoo? Para iya nang dawaton as a pleasing aroma before the Lord. Paul's dedication and commitment to hold firmly to God's word made him faithful in the service in the midst of suffering. And may our service, mga igsoon, also to others be a pleasing aroma diha sa Ginoo. To make that service pleasing before God, saon man, to make that service, to make your ministry pleasing at atubangan sa Ginoo. How? Be faithful in your service. Hello? Be faithful in your service. In your ministry for God, always be a faithful and a true servant. Kay ang tinuod nga commitment o pagservisyo can only be seen, makita lamang na mga igsoon, when we persevere in our trials and suffering. And though in the long run, kung maghandol ganitag mga ministry, in the long run, it will be painful. And always remember, God is with us. God is with us even though it is painful. And that is His promise to us, His people, if we observe all that God has commanded. Matthew 28:20, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, what? I am with you always to the end of the age. Teaching them to observe that I have commanded. Klaro kayo na, ha? Be faithful and observe what God has commanded. For God will always be with us to the very end of age. Also, ako ginaidugang, be diligent and persistent in your responsibilities, especially in meditating God's Word for continual growth in your spiritual walk. Be diligent. Chom nang diligent, bro. Ayaw pag tinapulan. Ayaw pag tinapulan sa pagtuon sa pulong sa Ginoo. And how can you be faithful in your service if you're not meditating God's Word? How can you be a good example to other people if you're not meditating and applying God's Word? And how will you be like Christ if we are not faithful to study, to meditate His Word? How can you be like Christ? Meditating on God's Word is essential for a faithful servant to find joy and to keep rejoicing in their service. And it is important to engage in the study of Scripture. Meditating on God's Word para atog yung masabtan unsa man giday purpose o kabubuton sa Ginoo sa akong kinabuhi. And not only to be faithful, not only to be faithful, but to be joyful in your service. Be joyful in your service. Verse 18, likewise, you also, what? Should be glad and rejoice with me. Paul said, likewise. Likewise, be glad. The word be glad, gikan na sa Greek word nga kairo. And be glad here is in the present imperative form. And the present tense indicate again a continuous or repeated action. It implies to continually experience joy or gladness in your service diha sa Ginoo. It's not a one-time action, but an ongoing disposition of joy while you are serving the Lord. And the focus emphasis is that this joy we have, kaning joy nga naa nato, while serving the Lord, will be manifested unta sa mga katauhan nga nagtanaw nimo. And this is not only about completing the task nga unsay gihatag sa Ginoo. It is about doing it willfully. What do you mean willfully? Willfully means without grumbling or disputing. Imo nang gibuhat kay nahigugma ka sa Ginoo tungod sa iyahang paghigugma nimo. And why do we need to rejoice in the Lord? Why do we need to rejoice in the Lord? Nehemiah 8:10, unsay gingon? Your favorite verse. The joy of the Lord is our strength. So may mong buot pasabot, ana, Brad. I would just go back to the story of Nehemiah, just gamay lang, no? When the walls of Jerusalem, mga isoon, were rebuilt, na purma na, Ezra and other Levites, mga priests, had brought the law of Moses before the assembly. Sama ni ini, no? And the people were listening to it. Naminaw ang mga tao ni Ezra while he was speaking or iyang gipaabot ang balaod ni Moses. And when the people heard the words of the law, they were deeply moved. Nangatandog sila, nakonbiktaran sila about their shortcomings and disobedience. And in response to that, mga izoon, Nehemiah, along with the priests and the Levites, iyang gi-encourage ang mga tao not to grieve excessively, but to find joy in the Lord. And Nehemiah wanted to redirect their focus from sorrow and encouraging the people to have the joy that comes from a renewed relationship diha sa Ginoo. And the joy of the Lord in Nehemiah's view, mga igsoon, was not a merely fleeting emotion. It's not only an emotion, but a source. Mosha, a source of enduring strength and a foundation for the ongoing restoration sa ilahang community. Kay during sa pag-rebuild nila sa walls, mga igsoon, grabe, daghan kaayo og babag nga halos wa na sila'y tulganay para lang mabuild na nga wall. And the joy of the Lord, mga igsoon, being their strength, express the idea that finding joy in their relationship with God, mauni maghatag nilag power or empowerment to face adversity with resiliency. Moni maghatag nilag kusog og kalig-on og maghatag og determinasyon para mahuman lang yun nila ang trabahoon para sa Ginoo. And it was a call. Tawag to siya to maintain a positive attitude grounded in the assurance of God's forgiveness and grace, mga igsoon. And that is why, kita mga Kristohanon, we need to rejoice in the Lord. We need to rejoice in the Lord because our relationship with God is renewed. Wa ba ka malipay ana mga igsoon? Your relationship with God is renewed. And that is because of His great love. And we are not consumed, for His compassions never fail. We need to rejoice in the Lord because we have been forgiven and not found guilty because of Jesus Christ. And that is by grace, not by our own efforts. We need to rejoice in the Lord because we have a God who is all-powerful to sustain us in the midst of the storms of life. That we need to be still and know that He is God and God alone. And Paul is an exemplary for us to follow. Because in the midst of his struggles, bisag naa siya sa prisuhan, nagsuwat ani ang iyang kalipay nga makita ang iyahang mga disciples na nalagad sa Ginoo, walay undang. And in his letter sa Philippians, mga igsoon, rejoicing is the word that has been repeated in the letter. Starting from chapter 1 to 4, the word rejoicing can be seen in Philippians 1:18. What then? Only that in every way, whether in pretense or in truth, Christ is proclaimed. And in that I rejoice, yes, and I will rejoice. Philippians 2:17-18, even if I am to be poured out as a drink offering upon the sacrificial offering of your faith, I am glad and rejoice with you all. Likewise, you also should be glad and rejoice with me. Philippians 3:1, finally, my brothers, rejoice in the Lord to write the same things to you in no trouble to me. And is safe for you. And the last is Philippians chapter 4, verse 4. What? Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. His closing remarks. And the repeated emphasis on joy and rejoicing, mga igsoon, that expresses the theme of maintaining a joyful spirit in various circumstances. And in my conclusion, ang atong mga kinabuhi, mga anak sa Ginoo, our lives are meant to stand out, not by conforming to the pattern of this world, but by reflecting the light of Christ. And this requires us to live with moral and spiritual integrity, shining brightly in a world that longs for genuine authenticity. Now, as we hold fast to the word of life, maunay atong source sa atong kusog, maunay source sa guidance nato. The concept of rejoicing in the Lord is not a mention, but a powerful perspective of the life. God's goodness. In times of difficulty and hardship, our ability to rejoice becomes a powerful statement that our hope is not dependent on our circumstances, but rather rooted in the character of the Lord. Just like I said earlier, just like a small glowing object stood out in the dark room, that smallest light can disperse darkness. And I would like to end this with a quote. As what Paul Washer said, the goal of God in your life is not prosperity. It's not health. It's not wealth. And it is most certainly not your best life now. God's goal, if you belong to Him, if you belong to God as a child, is to make you holy, to conform you in the image of Christ. Amen? Let us pray. Father God, we are so grateful for your word. We are so thankful, Father God. That's why we need to stop complaining and start rejoicing and to be satisfied with what we have right now. Lord, we just want to give you praises, adoration, for you are a God who is great and worthy to be praised. Yours alone be the glory, the power, dominion, and authority. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Praise.